Hello everyone, this is the Interim Assistant Professor of Suresh Gangaha University. Today we will going to discuss about essential plant nutrients, essential symptoms and nutrient movement to a plant root. So let's see. Nutrient movement to a plant roots. Plant absorb water through our roots and transpire the same through the foliage. As a transpiration ratio, the characteristics of the plant species, it is the amount of the water needed in a liter to produce 1 kg of a dry matter. This transpiration induces a flow of water from the soil to a plant root. With the flow of the water, nutrient ions dissolved in the moves the plant roots. These moving ions reach the plant root surface and become positionally available for absorption. Plant may have a differential water and nutrient requirement. There could be a three scenario. A root absorb the whole amount of a particular nutrient ion which reach with water of a root surface, and root need a more amount of the dead nutrient ions that reached the surface, thus creating a nutrient deficient the root surface. More nutrient raised at the root surface that what could be absorbed by the root. Under both the case is that B and C concentration gradient develops, and this concentration gradient makes the nutrient moves to the plant root. In case of boron, B and away from it in C. Thus, the transpiration process makes a nutrient move both with the water and through a water. Where's movement of the nutrient ion with the water in the classical physics is termed as the convective flow. That through a water is called a diffusive flow. Conceptually, conventive flow could include the movement of a nutrient with the eroding water, percolating water, or a water moving under the influence the transpiration demands of the plant. Jenny and Overstreet. Jenny and Overstreet 1939 assumed that the soil and root are two negatively charged plate closer to each other, having a swarm of nutrient it which the ions are the transferred for from soil particles to a root or vice versa without passing into solution. Such ions are oscillate in the in a small volume of space termed as a oscillations volume. Whenever the oscillations volume or two ions of a similar charge overlap, one is replaced for the other. The phenomena was termed as the contact exchange. Developing a root penetrate into the soil and explore the soil volume for water and nutrients. In this process, negatively charged roots come in contact with the negatively charged clay surface and interrupt the nutrient. Thank you. Thus, neutrons move by a three-distinct process: mass flow, diffusion, and root interpretation. Relative importance of this process in supplying nutrients in to a corn crop like nutrient nitrogen amount need for 9,500 kg grain hectare, so 190 root interpretation 2 and mass flow and 150 and diffusion 13. Its process along with the factor affecting it is described like a mass flow. Transpiration includes convective flow is termed as a mass flow. Defined as the movement of dissolved nutrient along with the water to the plant root, which the plant roots absorb a transpiration. The amount of a given nutrient supplied by the mass flow J can be computed by the using equation like J is equal to V into C, where the V is the amount of the water transpired during the cropping season to produce the given dry matter Y, and C1 is the average concentration of the nutrient ion in the bulk soil solution. Amount of the water used by the crop during the season is computed using either the transpiration ratio or amount of water used by the crop. This can be illustrated by the taking a wheat crop as an illustrative example. Let us assume that the wheat crop having a harvest index of the 0.4 produced a 4 ton grain yield per hectare. It has a transpiration ratio of the 300 or uses a 30 cm of water during the entire cropping season. Volume of water used could be calculated by the using either a transpiration ratio or a irrigation water used. Diffusion. One more factor affecting a mass flow, slow soil water content. The drier the soil, lesser in the mass flow. Introduce a nutrient movement. Temperature, low temperature, reduce the transpiration and evaporation and the consequent moment of the volume of the water and gets reduced you reduce it drastically. Size of the root system, both amount of water and the volume of soil is amount of the water and the volume of the soil is comes from get affected by the size of the root system. This effect water uptake, the therefore nutrients moving the air water, the root density is however less critical for the nutrient supply by the mass flow and for a root root interpretation and diffusion. Diffusion in a simple city, diffusion is a movement of nutrient through a water from an area of a high concentration to an area low concentration. As a root absorb a nutrient ion from the soil solution, concentration of root surface decreases compared to the bulk soil solution. As the consequence, the ions diffuse down the concentration gradient toward root surface before we already discussed on a mass flow. So diffusion is a principle supply a mechanism for the nutrient like phosphorus, potassium, iron and zinc that interact strongly with the soil. Diffused delivers the nutrient to the plant roots rather slowly. For example, distance moved by the nutrient by a diffusion is a 10 days away from a 1.3 centimeter space on the nitrate to 0.013 centimeter. So because of this diffusion assumed a significance only in the root rhizosphere. Diffusion flow of diffusion follows a thick laws which state that the amount of the nutrient ion moving per unit area per unit time proportional to concentration gradient. Factor affecting diffusive supplies factor which influence soil water diffuse of nutrient ions occurs through water. For diffuse to occur, continuity of moisture effluents is a must. In case of dry soil, since there is no continuity of the moisture effluents, defect diffusive movement will easy to occur. Intercriminal rise in water content rise the devalues as it makes the soil water less than or less less vesicous. Water films grow in size and reach level where most of the water is a bulk water as soil water content increase to a saturation the D tends to be maximum. Soil compaction, the soil solid, liquid and gaseous phase continue 15-35 of the soil on a volume basis incremental increases in the soil compaction at the same moisture content leads to the exclusion of air and soil particles come closer and the continuity of a moisture flow increase the diffusion coefficient. A gradual increase the diffusion coefficient reaches a maximum critical bulk density. When a hole of air is excluded and water occupies all the pore spaces above the bulk density, the diffusion coefficient exhibits the decreasing tendency as increase in the compaction beyond the critical bulk density makes solid particles come closer at the expense of the exclusion of the water and the physical hindrance. Temperature at a very low temperature diffusion virtually is easy because ions need some minimum activation energy for enabling them to participate in the reaction. Rise in the temperature in addition to overcoming this activation energy step increases fluidity or reduce the viscosity of water. This in turn facilitates the diffusion of the ions. Chemical amendments buffer power describe the quantitative relationship between concentration of nutrient ions plus a solution phase per centimeter cube of soil to concentration of the same ions in a solution per centimeter cube of solution. Chemical amendments as soil and gypsum and solid soil, manure and fertilizer, chelating agents, etc. modify the concentration of the nutrient ions in soil solution. We describe the quantitative relationship between a concentration values undergo a change as the result in the modification in nutrient ions in a soil. So For example, rise in a pH associated with the addition of the lime decrease the concentration of cation and increase the concentration of the ions of the soil solution. So as the consequence the diffusion coefficient of the cations so decrease, that of iron increase due to liming. Added calcium carbonate also progressively removes the cations from the soil solution through adsorption. Thus the including in thus the indu inducing there a buffer power to rise and effective diffusion coefficient defective to fall. Application of the gypsum in a sodic soil reduce the pH of the soil, as a result of which diffusion coefficient rises. Added organic manure release a low molecular weight biochemicals which have ability to form a soluble organic organometallic complex with the cation. These complexions causes a reduction in a buffer power and the increases in the D values. Root interception. This is the terms used in describe the soil nutrient. The root surface that don't have a mood to the interface to become available for absorption. The quantity of nutrient ion supplied by the root root interceptance, the taken as a quantity present in the volume of the soil equal to a root volume. Although relatively smaller, its contribution is significant for the nutrient present in a higher concentration. Example, calcium and magnesium, and also for the nutrient required in a small amount of zinc, manganese, and other micronutrients. Fungal infections, VM infections on highly infertile soil plays a significant role in increasing the contributions of root interceptors factor, which restrict root growth, like soil dryness, compaction, low pH, poor aeration, root disease including insect attack and nematode infection. The abnormally high or low soil temperature reduce the contribution of the root interceptions. However, it has been now established that root interception is not an independent mechanism, and the contribution assigned to that include in the mass flow and diffusion process. Ionic absorption by ionic absorption by a plant. Moment an nutrients reach the root surface, these penetrate the root by the passive movement into free space and reach closer to the root surface, where these have an opportunity to get either absorbed on the negatively charged root because of a root cation exchange capacity, or get located near them as a ion counter balancing the cations for maintaining electro neutralite, and finally enter the plant cell and accumulated the accumulated and redistributed into the translocate to different plant parts. Root properties, including root structure and the anatomy, are important determinations, and the magnitude of ionic absorption. Root anatomy and structure. Root cap covers the apical meristem, both tissues, and the tip of the root, and the produce as a slimy substance. This has root is more easily going through the ground. Apical meristem replace cell of the root cap as they are the damaged. Downward section of a primary root. The exudates of the outer epidermal layer. Epidermis covers the outside of the root, and the exudates called root hair. Root hair that absorb the water and minerals, and increase the surface area of root. The core of the root, called a vascular cylinder, contains xylem and phloem. A band of a ground tissue called a cortex surrounded the vascular cylinder. A single cell layer called endodermis separates the cortex and the vascular tissues. Endodermal cell are coated with the waxy layer called a Casperon strip. Ionic absorption channel. Ionic mineral nutrients are absorbed by the plants from the soil solution in ionic form. For example, potassium, nitrate form, phosphatic form, sulfate. And the ions have a two possible pathway for a root uptake. Through a apoplasm, cell wall, and intercellular space. And second one is movement cell to cell. The semiplasma through a living cell. The apoplasmic pathway, the blocked at endodermis by a Casperin band, deposit of a hydrophobic material in the cell wall. This apoplasmic barriers force the water and ions to move through a cellular membrane. If they are to be absorbed by the root, the Casperin bands that block apoplasmic movement of the ions are essential to sensitivity. Transport in the membrane of a plant cell. For any given nutrient, ion to be accumulated by the plant, it must be transported across root cell membrane. Regulation for this transporters enable control of internal nutrient composition, like selective and concentration. For purpose of understanding differential ionic selectivity, knowledge of the structure of the plant cell is a must. Each plant cell is characterized and the separated from each other by the cell wall, which encloses and houses the nucleus and the organelle. C as on the its inner sides a semi permeable membrane called a plasma membrane or a plasma plasma mammilla allows only selective absorption by of ions. The jelly like fluid made by of mostly water and salt fills the cell is called a cytoplasm solution. Outside the cell wall, which is ready to move into the cytoplasm, is called a opoplasm. Cytoplasm contains all the organelles, chloroplast and endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, mitochondria, microfilaments, microtubules, and mitochondria in nucleus. Peroxisome, ribosome, and vasculars. From ionic absorption perspective, with each cell has a single large side and vascular. Accumulating in organic and the organic molecules along with the water, these are the separated from the cytoplasma by a semi permeable and membrane called a chondroplast. Thus, to each and the vascular ion has to cross two semi-permeable membranes. First, plasma lamina and the chondroplast. Semi-permeable membrane allow the selective absorption of nutrient, best described by the carrier hypothesis theory pronounced by the Epstein 1953. Those basic features of the described here. Carrier hypothesis, this theory pronounced by the Epstein 1953, recognized as the existence of the carrier molecule on the semi-permeable cell. Semi-permeable cell or these molecule are called a carrier because this possess the specific because this process the specific binding site for a particular ions according to this theory, ions transported to the surface of plant roots the soil combined with the carrier molecular forming and the ion carrier complex. Semi permeable membrane allows the selective diffusion and the ion carrier complex into the cytoplasm. Ion uptake involving carrier molecular is the in this scheme, and ions combinations with the carrier molecular are phosphorylated compounds forming and the ion carrier complex. This ion carrier complex preferentially diffusing across the membrane encounters the phosphate enzymes, which split off the phosphate of the complex, and as a result the carrier losses its affinity for the ion, and the ion is released into the cytoplasm. This released carriers in regenerated and activated by the phosphokinase enzyme located on the inner side of the boundary for utilization of energy release from the breakdown of the ATP. This activated carriers against the traverses to the outer side of the plasma membrane and intercepts and ions transport it across the plasma membrane, losses ion to the cytoplasm and losses its activity. It gets regenerated and the cycle goes on the chemically. This cycle has been created by the Mengel and the Kriegbeier 1982. Phosphokinase carrier plus ATP reaction carriers phosphorus plus ADP. After that, the carriers phosphorus plus iron. So it reacts carriers phosphorus iron and carriers phosphorus and ions. So phosphate carriers plus phosphorus first and ions and net ions and ATP. React ion plus ADP and phosphate. Nutrient ion uptake by a plant root is a diagrammatically described by a Mengel and Kriegbeier. Relationship is a based best described by the equation famously called as the Marchley's Menten and kinetics equation in entomology. Conclusion plant conclusion and 17 elements calcium, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sulfur, iron, magnesium, zinc, copper, nickel, boron, molybdenum, and chlorine have been identified to be essential for a completion of the plant life cycle. But out of this requirement of the CHO, carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen are met from air and water. Rest are the absorbed from the soil by the plant roots. As per quantity based on classification, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, and sulfur are classified as a mesonutrient, and iron, manganese, and zinc, copper, nickel, boron, and chlorine as a micronutrient. But all are the apps. Absolutely absolutely indispensable for a plant growth in relation to the nutrient level to soil. Native or applied is described by the growth laws pronounced by the Liebig law, law of minimum, and Mischler's law of physiological relationship, and the Wallen's law of maximum. Bray's concept of the nutrient availability and mobility have been the most outstanding addition to the contemporary development in the field of the plant nutrition. Soil plant quantum soil with respect to the nutrient dynamic has been excessive or reliable, and the process of the nutrient movement to the plant root and their ultimate absorption in plant roots have been under supply nutrient to a plant roots, and once this reach to a root surface and absorb the activity of the passively by the plant root with the without expenditure of the energy following well-known theories of ionic absorption, out of the which Stefan Carrier's hypothesis has been most extensively used in nutrient uptake modeling study. Principles supply a mechanism for the nutrient like phosphorus, potassium, iron, and zinc that interact strongly with the soil. Diffuse delivers the nutrient to the plant roots rather slowly. For example, distance moved by the nutrient by a diffusion is 10 days away from 1.3 centimeters is on the nitrate. 2.013 centimeter. So because of this diffusion assumed a significance only in the root rhizosphere. Diffusion flow of diffusion follows a thick laws which state that the amount of the nutrient ion moving per unit area per unit time proportional to concentration gradient. Factor affecting diffusive supplies factor which influences soil water diffuse of nutrient ions occurs through water. For diffuse to occur, continuity of moisture affluence is a must. In case of dry soil, since there is no continuity of the moisture affluence defect, diffusive movement will easy to occur. Intercriminal rise in water content rise the devalues as it makes the soil water less than a less less vesicous. Water films grow in size and reach level where most of the water is a bulk water as soil water content increase to a saturation and the D tends to be maximum. Soil compaction, the soil solid, liquid and gaseous phase consider 15-35 of the soil on a volume basis incremental increases in the soil compaction at the same moisture content leads to the exclusion of air and soil particles come closer and the continuity of a moisture flow increase the diffusion coefficient. A gradual increase the diffusion coefficient reaches a maximum critical bulk density. When a whole of air is excluded and water occupies all the pore spaces above the bulk density, the diffusion coefficient exhibits the decreasing tendency as increase in the compaction beyond the critical bulk density makes solid particles come closer at the expense of the exclusion of the water and the physical hindrance.
reduce the diesel coefficient. They temperature at a very low temperature diffusion virtually as easy because ions need some minimum activation energy for enabling them to participate. In the reaction, rise in the temperature in addition to overcoming this activation energy step increases fluidity or reduce the viscosity of water. This in turn facilitates the diffusion of the ions. Chemical amendments, buffer power describe the quantitative relationship between concentration of neutron ions plus a solution phase per centimeter cube of soil to concentration of the same ions in a solution per centimeter cube of solution. Chemical amendments and soil and gypsum and solid soil, manure and fertilizer, chelating agents, etc., modify the concentration of the nutrient ions in soil solution. We describe the quantitative relationship between a concentration values undergo a change as the result in the modification in nutrient ions in our soil. So, for example, rise in pH associated with the addition of the lime decrease the concentration of cation and increase the concentration of the ions of the soil solution. So, as the consequence, the diffusion coefficient of the cations should decrease that of iron increase due to liming. Added calcium carbonate also progressively removes the cations from the soil solution through adsorption. Inducing their buffer power to rise and effective diffusion coefficient defect to fall. Application of the gypsum in a sodic soil reduce the pH of the soil as a result of which diffusion coefficient rises. Added organic manure release a low molecular weight biochemicals which have ability to form a soluble organic organometallic complex with the cation. These complexions causes a reduction in the buffer power and the increases in the D values. Root interception, this is the terms used in describe the soil nutrient. The root surface data don't have a move to the interface to become available for absorption. The quantity of nutrient ion supplied by the root root interceptance, the taken as a quantity present in the volume of the soil equal to a root volume. Although relatively smaller, its contribution is significant for the nutrient present in a higher concentration. Example, calcium and magnesium, and also for the nutrient required in a small amount of zinc, manganese, and other micronutrient. Fungal infections, VM infections on highly infertile soil plays a significant role in increasing the contributions of root interspersed factor, which restrict root growth like soil dryness, compaction, low pH, poor aeration, root disease, including insect attack and nematode infection. The abnormally high or low soil temperature, reduce the contribution of the root interceptions. However, it has been now established that root interception is not an independent mechanism, and the contribution assigned to it get included in the mass flow and diffusion process. Ionic absorption by ionic absorption by a plant moment and nutrients reach the root surface, these penetrate the root by the passive movement into free space and reach closer to the root surface, where these have an opportunity to get either absorbed on the negatively charged root because of a root cation exchange capacity, or get located near them as an ion counter balancing the cation cations for maintaining electro neutralite, and finally enter the plant cell and accumulated the accumulated and redistribute into the translocate to different plant parts. Root properties including root structure and anatomy are important determinations, and the magnitude of ionic absorption. Root anatomy and structure. Root cap covers the apical meristem, both tissues, and the tip of the root, and the produce as a slimy substance. This hard root is more easily going through the ground. Apical meristem replace cell of the root cap as they are the damaged. Terminal section of a primary root, the exudates of the outer epidermal layer. Epidermis covers the outside of the root, and the exudates called root hair.